like to introduce yourself?
Yes, sure. My name is Lao Sok Kee, and you can call me Lao. I'm an undergraduate student from Design UM.
Thank you, Lao. Lao, can you tell me your understand about frog?
Frog? I think frog is like a intended wrongdoing of a person to like gain the benefits for his own financial support or also for others' personal gains.
So do you know more specific about the revenue and also inventory fraud?
Revenue and inventory fraud? I think that the revenue fraud is like the wrongdoing related to the income generated in an organization, such as like maybe they will alternate the incomes or also create the fictitious sales, and like maybe they will understate their net profit to avoid taxation. However, for the inventories fraud, I think that it's like maybe incur the theft of the inventory, or also like maybe they will understate their inventories to like overstate the cost of goods sold. So by overstating the cost of goods sold, maybe they will like also reduce their net profit lah.
For example, the inventory fraud, it can be says that when someone understand its inventory that he buy and understand the real amount and create a fictitious amount in his account, right? And for the revenue fraud, it also can be happen when someone sells it goods and also service to the customer and create a fictitious amount. And it also he maybe will not record the returns good when it's real happen.
Oh, I see. So he or she manipulates the amount to like maybe like to show a better performance, is it?
You are right. So can you tell me, do you join any organization or club in the UUM?
Yes, I joined the Life Saver and Swimming Club in UUM.
So what is the possibility of fraud that can you commit in your club? Can you tell me?
The possibility of the fraud, I think for the revenue fraud is maybe like we overstated the expenses for claim, and then we will like understate the income, so we will like have more money claim that we can cover the actual cost. So but for the inventory fraud, I think that maybe it will incur the theft of the inventory, because our swimming caps and also goggles we put in a storeroom, and the storeroom can be easily entered by anyone, so it will like the high probability to like involve the theft of inventory lah, because we don't know who will steal the swimming caps, and we have the case last time like this, but we also don't know who has stole the swimming caps also. However, I'm the president of the club, and I'm also holding another position, which is the treasurer. So it's will like the high possibility for me to manipulate the amounts. Like maybe I will understate the inventories and overstate the income, or somehow to like for my own benefits, or either to show the better performance for their for the club financial statement.
It sounds very interesting and easier for you to commit fraud, right? As there is no any segregation of duty and you hold many positions, right? Okay, thank you, Lao. That's all for today, our interview. Thanks for spending your time to me.
Okay, not at all. Thank you too.
Hi, boleh tanya beberapa soalan. So, you kerja sini kan? So, what is the possibility of you to commit to this inventory fraud and also revenue fraud?
Saya kan kerja kat sini semua. So, I can do anything what I want to do, right?
Yeah.
So, no one know about what I did. For example, saya tulis dekat report tu RM250. Lepas tu, yang terjadi tu RM200 je. RM50 boleh lah saya ambil kan sebab tak ada orang tahu kan. Ya, itulah macam tu Isa.
So what is the possibility of the inventory fraud that you can do?
Macam for example saya ni boleh lah ambil air, ambil makanan, ambil apa coklat, apa ke yang saya nak. Saya boleh guna seorang. Sebab tak ada orang tahu kan. Ya. Jadi saya ambil guna seorang, saya tak bayar pun.
Adakah Encik tahu apa itu penipuan stok dan penipuan hasil?
Tahu.
Oh, okey. Kalau macam tu, apakah kemungkinan penipuan yang akan berlaku dalam bisnes photostat ni?
Kita order lebih. Contoh, keperluan 100, kita order 20. Maknanya 20 tu untuk kegunaan kita sendiri. Satu lagi, receipt boleh buat kan?
Oh, receipt yang tulis di tangan, dia bukan print. Jadi, kalau receipt rekod tu?
Receipt rekod tu mungkin susah sikit. Sebab, inventory mungkin kita bilang by minggu. By minggu, maknanya item yang kita kira tu dia tak lain dengan jumlah sale yang kita dapat. Kalau kita guna receipt yang bertulis, yang tu.
Yes, dia order sebanyak ni tapi dia mungkin tulis lebih mahal sikit lah. Then duit lebih tu dia akan masuk kes sendiri lah. Kalau macam mana, ada tak kemungkinan dia akan kurangkan hasil untuk macam kurangkan cukai ke?
Kalau ikut order, kita akan lebih. Tapi kita declare hasil, jumlah hand order tu. Ya, kat situ lah kita boleh nampak dia lari.
Yang inventory tu order banyak, kos mahal, then income dia sama. Jadi untung bersih tu kurang lah. Jadi sana boleh kurangkan cukai lah.